Hey, how's it going? This is Seth from REtipster.com, and in this video, I'm going to give you an overview of a website called PandaDoc. So what is PandaDoc? PandaDoc is a service that can allow you to get digital signatures from people. These are legally binding signatures. All these digital signature services can do this like digital fingerprinting, where it does a geolocation of the person and their IP address and all this stuff. So you can be pretty darn certain that whoever is signing this document really is that person. And you can certainly survive without something like PandaDoc. It's just a lot more cumbersome and time consuming, because without something like this, you would have to send the person a Word document or a PDF. They would have to then print the thing out, if they have a printer nearby at all, and then sign the thing, and then somehow scan it and email it back to you, or take a picture and email it back to you. And it's not really the most secure way to be sending around documents like this with sensitive information. And PandaDoc just makes it a lot simpler and more seamless and just cleaner. And PandaDoc also has a really well-made mobile app, so you can do a lot of this stuff without even being in front of your computer. And REtipster does have an affiliate link with PandaDoc. It's retipster.com/PandaDoc, and you can get started for free. So I'm going to go up here and click on pricing, and you can see right down here, free e-sign upload, send for signature, and collect payments for as many documents as you like. So you certainly can get started for free here, but as we're going to see in just a few minutes, there are some limitations that come into play pretty quickly if you don't have a paid plan, or at least sign up for a trial of the paid plan. So we can go ahead and get started with this, but if you're seriously going to use this thing again and again and again, chances are you're going to need some kind of a basic paid plan. But if you just want to try this out and get started and see how it works, as we're going to do here, you can do that for free. So let's go ahead and do that. Go ahead and click on this, and I'll put my name in here, and let's sign up. Okay, so if we wanted to invite other people to use this thing, we could do that if we had a lot of other team members. I'm going to skip this for now. And I've got a purchase agreement that I need to get signed by two other people and myself. So I'm just going to take that Word document and drop it right here. I could also do it with a PDF. Or if I had this document stored in my Google Drive account or Dropbox or someplace else, I could grab it from there too. But I'm just going to drag it here right from a folder on my computer. Go ahead and put it right there. And it says, want to convert your document into an editable PandaDoc. Sure, let's give it a try. See how this works. Okay, so for recipients, I'm going to put myself in here and also the two people I'm trying to send this to. Go ahead and add those addresses here. And okay, now we've got them all in there. Go ahead and click continue, move on to the next step. All right, so now we've got our document, and it looks slightly different than how I originally set it up here. Looks like some margins are a little bit in different places, but for the most part, it didn't change a whole lot. Alternatively, I could have just not converted this into a PandaDoc version of the document, and it probably would have been exactly the way I originally had it. But needless to say, all the stuff is here. And one thing to keep in mind whenever you're using a service like this is that just as a general rule, the less stuff you have to do once it's in here, the better. Like, I don't want to necessarily edit all of my stuff in PandaDoc. I want to pretty much have it all exactly how it needs to be with all the information entered in, then upload it, so that all I need to do is put the signature block and date fields exactly where they need to be, and then I can click next and move on. So I'm going to put my signature block right in here, and all I have to do is move it right there, right above my name, and then take the date and put that right here. And I can also select the date at which it's going to happen. And then I can move on here to the next person who needs to sign and do the exact same thing for them. Take their signature block and put it right there by their name, and then their date field, and put that right here. And then this last person here, select their name, same thing. Put their signature block right there, and take their date field and put that right there. And yeah, it's as simple as that. It's just a matter of selecting the right names and putting the signature blocks in the right places so that I'm not signing above their name, or they're not signing above my name. Just, you know, put the right things in the right spot. Not a hard thing to do at all. And all the names and email addresses have already been entered in. And if I did want to add other stuff here, I could, but this is a pretty simple, straightforward document. So at this point, all I got to do is click send. And it looks like in terms of sending this, I could either send them an email or share a link. And that link option might be kind of nice, actually, if, say, the conversation was happening all through texting or Facebook Messenger or some other medium. It could be a lot easier to just do that instead of sending it to an email address that they might not ever check or that might get sent to spam. So just to be sure I have this link, I'm going to go ahead and... Okay, looks like we just hit our first limitation on the free plan. Okay, well, I guess I'm going to go ahead and start that 14-day free trial so that I can get that link. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and sign up for this and start this free 14-day trial. Okay, so now we're going to go back over here to send, and I'm going to quick grab this link, save and continue. And it looks like we can generate individual links for each person who needs to sign. Let's go ahead and do that, and then we can copy this thing and the other one and either text it to that person or email it or Facebook message it or whatever you want to do. Those links are there. So I'm going to go ahead and actually copy this and just go ahead and see what the experience looks like for myself when I go through to sign this thing. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a new incognito window just so that I'm not logged in. And this is what a person would see. So this thing opens up. Go ahead and click start. It just brings me right down here. I can sign that and accept and sign and finish. And there we go. That's all done. And the other people are going to have to do the exact same thing. But you can see how quick and simple and easy that was. So they don't need to print anything out or have a pen nearby or scan anything back. As long as they have some kind of mobile device with access to the internet in some way, shape, or form, they can do this thing right out in the field if they need to. And I don't want to gloss over that because that's actually a really huge convenience and reason to use something like PandaDoc. The whole thing with this particular deal that I'm working on right now is I've got two buyers who are visiting a property, but they're from across the country. So they're like traveling, they're on the road right now. They don't have their main computer with them. They don't have a printer. So if I was to send them this document and tell them to print the thing, sign it, and scan it back to me, they can't do it because they don't have that stuff. Or at least it would be highly inconvenient for them to try to track that down somewhere. So if this is something that absolutely needs to happen before I can move forward, we're stuck. Unless I have something like PandaDoc, where they can not only take care of everything from their mobile device, but it's also a lot more secure than scanning something that might have sensitive information on it and just attaching it with no other security and sending it through the email. That's generally not a very good practice. And something like PandaDoc can work for that as well. Even if these people did have their computer and printer and scanner right there ready to go, it still would be better to use PandaDoc than that because it's more secure and it's like a couple clicks and you're done instead of a lot more cumbersome, annoying steps. So I think PandaDoc is a pretty solid option to use. Certainly not the only one out there, but if you're looking for something like this to make things a lot more convenient and secure, I wanted to make sure you knew about it. And now we play the waiting game until those signatures come through. But whenever they do come through, we can see on our dashboard, it's really easy to just see what's going on at a glance, what's out there, who's viewed it, who's completed it. Pretty straightforward and easy to use. So there you go. If you need a quick, convenient way to get digital signatures, I think PandaDoc is a pretty solid choice to go with. Definitely not the only one out there. There's other great ones out there as well, but PandaDoc is good enough that I think I can vouch for it on my end anyway. Again, if you want to check out PandaDoc, we've got an affiliate link beneath this video. And if you'd rather use something else, that's totally cool too. I wish you all the best. Thanks for watching. Talk to you next time.